Hello, everybody. Welcome to Introduction to Accounting Part 2. And we're going to be talking about what is an asset. I am the accounting professor on YouTube. My name is Bennett Tchaikovsky. So remember what we're doing here. We are escaping from reality and imagining a world in where all transactions happen on only on December 31st. We are focusing on assets, liabilities, and stockholders' equity. What exactly is an asset? An asset is going to be an item that gives us future economic benefit. What is an asset? Cash. I can use that cash to go through and purchase items, or I can pay for services. Accounts receivable. I've performed services for somebody else, but I have not yet been paid. Inventory, an item that I can turn around and then sell later. Prepaids and other assets. I bought an insurance policy that's giving us future economic benefit in the form of future insurance coverage. That is going to be prepaid insurance or an asset. Investments. I had excess cash, so I decided to buy some stocks, bonds, and other securities of other companies. Deposits. I gave a landlord a deposit in order for myself to move into the building. If that deposit is refundable, that is going to be a future economic, that asset is going to be an asset with future economic benefit. Loans receivable. I gave money to somebody else. So loans receivable, I've loaned them money. Hopefully they're going to be paying me back. Interest receivable. I never loan money for free. The interest that has not yet been paid to me is going to be interest receivable. PPE, personal protective equipment. No, it is property, plant, and equipment. And this is for accounting. What is PP&E? It is cars, vehicles, equipment that we're using in our business operations. Lastly, we have intangible assets. Can't touch this. Well, what is an intangible asset? I've purchased a patent. I've purchased film rights. I have a trademark. I paid over the amount of the fair value of assets, and that is what is known as goodwill. So these are all common assets. Now, as we learn more in accounting, you're not going to see all these immediately, but you will see them eventually. What are not assets? Our employees are our greatest assets. No, they're saying that to you to make you feel good and have you stay there. An employee is not an asset. But however, when Mr. Ballmer purchased the LA Clippers, those contracts, those player contracts had an asset value. But again, it's going to be not really the case most of the time. I'm worth this, a self-inflated worth. No, we're not going to be going through and recognizing that until transactions happen. Now, Tesla, right? Tesla has lots of data from self-driving. So are those assets for accounting purposes? And the answer is not yet. Someone would have to come in and buy Tesla, which I'm not sure if that's going to happen at this point, but if someone comes in and purchases Tesla, they would be assigning a value to that data. Just like when the metaverse or Meta platforms purchased Instagram, if you go through and look through some of their public filings, you'll see some really creepy stuff. You and I were sold. Right over here, appreciated real estate, right? I don't write up assets arbitrarily. It has to be in a transaction. The most important thing, though, that you need to kind of go through and realize as you're going through and looking at companies is every company has different types of assets. Tesla, they've got cash, short-term marketable securities, receivables, inventory, prepaid expenses. Solar energy systems, right? Over here, net $5.7 billion. So digital assets, net, what are those? We could go through and look through the financial statements or the footnotes of the companies to figure out what that is. So again, as we're going through and looking at these different GameStop, right? GameStop, cash, receivables, inventory, we kind of start seeing a commonality. All depends on the industry. For Meta platforms, cash, marketable securities, receivables, prepaid expenses, property and equipment, goodwill. Over here, we have NVIDIA, cash, securities, inventories, prepaids, property and equipment, goodwill, intangible assets, deferred tax assets, meaning I've paid the taxes already, but I haven't yet received the benefit of it. So let's take a look at a few more. We've got Netflix. What does Netflix have right over here? They've got cash and cash equivalents. These are in thousands of dollars. Other current assets, content assets, right? Squid Games, Red Light, Green Light, fun stuff. So right over here, that's what you have for Netflix. over here for the Walt Disney Company, right? This is what we're looking at right over here. And this is the Walt Disney Company. And when we look over here at Disney's assets, cash and cash equivalents, receivables, inventories, content advances, meaning they've paid for content that they have not yet received back from their producers yet, or from the from their producers, produce and license content costs, investments, park resorts and other property, attractions, building and equipment, $64 billion. So with Disney, right, they're going to have, like, Netflix doesn't have the Squid Games game theme park built yet, but Disney does. Well, not Squid Games, but other games. But over here, you've got other intangible assets, goodwill. So as we look at this, every single company, right, has different types of assets that are happening. I didn't look at Amazon today, but we can do that another day. And if you would like to see that, please feel free to ask, leave any kind of questions that you have below. And I want to thank you and appreciate your liking and subscribing to these videos. Have a great rest of your day.